minor in theater, and here I was broke. I was making less than $10 an hour. I have a child that I'm raising myself, and I had an apartment I had to pay rent for. I wasn't on any kind of assistance or anything, and I'm just like, how am I even living? Like, what the heck am I doing? Like, I'm not okay with being in this space. So when I started writing in that journal, I then began to challenge myself. I knew that I was fully equipped. I knew that making $9 an hour, I didn't move from Arkansas to St. Louis to struggle. That's why I left Arkansas. So I just really had to develop myself and get myself together and really challenge myself to become better. And I remember after that job, I was like, I'm not taking $9 or $10 an hour ever again, because I'm more qualified than that, dude. I can't live off that. And I remember the young lady calling me at this temp agency. She was like, well, we have a job for you. It's $10 an hour. I was like, no, I'm not taking that. And she was like, well, it's good money. And I was just like, $10, come on. All right, $10, and there's nothing wrong with $10 for like a teenager. But if you have like, but if you're a grown person with a degree, with experience, you shouldn't have to take what's dished out. So I didn't take that $10. And the next job, the next person that called me, I think it was 3 days later, they offered me a job for $23. And obviously I took that job. But I'm just saying, just imagine what if I didn't. And that's what some of us do. We just take whatever is dished out, and we continue to get lack, and we continue to sit in that lack without getting out of it. And I say get out. And once you're getting out, create a vision board. I know a lot of people create vision boards, and what it is, if you don't know what it is what I do with my vision board is I cut a lot of different things out from magazines, words, like what's on there right now is I'm going to be on the Steve Harvey show talking about my book. I'm going to be on the Steve Harvey show talking about my book, just so you know. So that's one thing on there. And then another thing on there is that I want to move out of Arkansas. I did that. And then I have pictures of my old body when my stomach was completely flat, when I was saying that it was big and it wasn't. So I have that on there. I have the man that I want to marry and my book. I spoke about my book on there before my book was even born. And then back when I had that Ford Taurus, I put a new car on there, and then I got my new car right after that. So all these things that you put on this vision board, you want to see it, you want to believe it, you want to put it somewhere where you can see it every day. Mine is in my closet. So as soon as I walk straight into my closet, bam, it's right there. And then around my house, because I know what I want my body to work on and I'm working on that, I have pictures of myself when I was at my best, literally everywhere all around my house. So you definitely want to come up with that vision board and be proactive about getting those things that are on that vision board, because you can have those things. I believe if you ask, you seek, you knock, you ask for it, God will present it for you. You seek it, you expect it. You wake up every day with expectancy. You're going to get what you're looking for. And you knock on that door, he's going to open it if it's in his will. And if not, he'll give you something even better. So ask, seek, and knock. And I have a note in my car that says, I'm a money magnet. I am financially stable. Money finds me daily.